Jimmy G. Jimmy Garoppolo missed last week. He's got an ankle injury. Backup Nick Mullins filled in admirably. And the Jets and the Giants still couldn't beat the Niners. With 340-plus yards, a touchdown, they beat the Giants. It was a lopsided game. Now, Mullins is expected to start this week as well, with Jimmy missing practice the past few days. And head coach Kyle Shanahan was asked if Mullins could supplant Jimmy G if he plays well. See, that's what an elite, a terrific, a real asset of a head coach does. Even if he doesn't fully believe that, that's what you project. That's what you say. Good job by Shanahan. I'm sure he does believe it, but... Yeah. In or out, we are convinced that Jimmy is capable of leading a team to a Super Bowl title.
I'm going
to
say in bounds of this, BT. They were in the Super Bowl last year and just a few quarters away, a few minutes away, I should say, from winning a Super Bowl title. So, yeah, of course he can. Now, Nick Mullins played well. He threw some nice balls last night, or last weekend, I should say, against the New York Giants. But this team, Jimmy Garoppolo is paid to be their leader. He is their leader. Everybody trusts and believes in him. Mm-hmm. There's no doubt in my mind that he can get them back as long as they stay healthy, which might limit them from getting back. But eventually, this team is healthy. They have the right coaching staff. Jimmy G is their guy. I don't question that.
He's definitely their guy. But my answer is out of bounds to this, and I've changed my answer on this. If this was asked, certainly last year I would have said inbounds. If this was asked, maybe even over the summer, I may have been inclined to say inbounds. But the circumstances have changed for a couple of reasons. Number one, some of the teams around them are maybe a little bit better than I thought, like Green Bay, certainly one of them. Seattle's a little bit better than I thought as well, though Seattle needs to get healthy. Mm-hmm. But speaking of health, I mean, the Niners are a mess, which is a big reason why I say out of bounds. Now, again, I'm playing a little bit into the literal aspect of the interpretation of the question, leading a team to a Super Bowl title. If it said, could he win this? Yeah, then I'd say maybe, but maybe even still no there. But leading implies, you know, he's the main force behind it. And I don't see it that way. And he's going to have to be the main force behind it, because without Bosa and without some of their weaponry, their defense certainly is not nearly as formidable as they were a year ago. They'll probably never be as formidable again as Jimmy's in his prime. I don't mean 10, 12, I mean the next iteration could be. But this team changed. This team has changed. I think that the window has shut. I think that's it. I think they got to the Super Bowl. They lost. And you know what? Quite frankly, if Jimmy G would have put that one ball a little bit 2 yards more on the numbers, or actually on the hands, it's a touchdown, they win. I think they missed their – they're still going to be good. But I do not think that they will win a Super Bowl with this team, so my answer is out of bounds. As expected, Doc was named the head coach of the River – of the Sixers yesterday. Doc Rivers now questions around their roster, something you and I brought up on the show yesterday, their finances – shall we say, are a little out of whack. Second highest expected payroll going into 2021. I actually thought it was first, but it says second here. Either way, it's not good. And many believe they could trade either Embiid or Simmons. However, there's early reports coming out of Philly that say GM Elton Brand wants to see what Doc can do with Embiid and Simmons together. In or out, Philly's a top five seed in the East next year as currently constructed.
Out of bounds, not as currently constructed. Wow. They will move either Tobias Harris or Al Horford. That, you can guarantee that, BT. But I think Joel Embiid and Ben Simmons are going to stay together, and this is why you bring in Doc Rivers. In fact, once Doc Rivers agreed to part ways with the L.A. Clippers, the courting of Mike D'Antoni went to the wayside. Elton Brand and Josh Harris, the owner, made a beeline to make this deal happen, and that's why we saw it happen so quickly. And the reason is because Doc is more of a teacher. This is what these guys need. They need a teacher to teach them how to play together, how to get Joel Embiid to stay in shape and stay healthy, Ben Simmons to become more of a leader, and hell, just take a few of them a game, three-pointers, be some sort of a stretch for us. And so I think when Josh and Elton saw that this was an availability, it was a no-brainer.
Yep.
For them to alter course and bring in Doc Rivers. But I don't think, as currently constructed, without a shooter, that they're going to be able to they're going to put this court on the team on the court next season. They'll make a trade, maybe for Buddy Hield, maybe for somebody like that. It'll happen.
Boy, Buddy Hield be stroking it. Why be open all night on that team?
Right.
Buddy Hield, huh?
That's
but right. What would you have to give up to get Buddy Hield? Ben Simmons? I don't think Tobias is going to fly.
Draft picks. I don't know.
Maybe.
You got to get creative. But they have to get creative. They can't win with the team. that they put on the court last year.
They can't win with the team they had on the court last year. Agreed. Do I think they could be a top five seed in the Eastern Conference with the team they put on the court last year with some modifications, primarily from the coaching seat? I do. I actually do. I don't know that I'd bet a lot on this, but you know, Celtics are good. Yep. Mets should be pretty good. Toronto's always interesting. Miami, got to give them, of course, Milwaukee. Those are five teams off the top of my head. Yep. You know, Pacers are always there as well, whatever. Mm-hmm. The Magic are ascending in theory. We'll see what happens there. But I think it's going to be really hard to trade Horford, making $20 million a year, whatever. I think maybe $20 million for the next couple of years.
Yep.
Tobias is making $35 million. So I actually like this approach. I love that they hired Doc over Mike D'Antoni. Right move, better move, smart pivot, well done. But now I need to see, or I would want to see, I subscribe to the thought, let Doc get them in training camp together, let Doc coach them up. Yep. Before you ship one of those stars out, see if you can make it work. I like that strategy.
Let Doc decide.
Yes, yes. All right, Clayton Kershaw, three Cy Youngs, an MVP, modern version of Sandy Koufax, you know, Randy Johnson more recently, but his postseason numbers, not very good, well documented. Future Hall of Famer, lock. 10-11, all right, win circumstantial, but the ERA is well over 4 in 26 playoff starts. And before last night, he was 0-3 in his last 4 playoff starts with an ERA over 7. So the most recent small sample, really bad. However, he was pretty dominant last night. He bounced the Brewers. They were eliminated. 8 shutout frames, and he allowed just 3 hits, and he whiffed 13. So Kershaw was vintage. In or out, Kershaw will finally be effective throughout the entire postseason.
Yeah, I'm going to say inbounds of this, BT. Okay. And I think a lot of it's because of what we talked about yesterday with Walker Buehler. Clayton Kershaw is not the guy. He's not the man. He's not the ace. He still has ace stuff on days like yesterday. And so it gives him, there's a little bit of a less pressure on him to be that guy. Also, I can't discount that he was likely battling injuries, for the last few years. Mm-hmm. It obviously manifested itself last season. But he seems healthy right now, and that's only going to portend good things for this LA Dodgers squad, who obviously have the bats and the fielding to get this thing done. If their pitching holds up, and I think it will, they're going to be viable again for a championship.
Well, I mean, they won 106 games a year ago. They're the number one seed this year. They got two guys on the bench who probably bat fifth on teams.
Right.
They've got an injection of athleticism, obviously, with Mookie Betts doing his thing. You know, I'm going to say out of bounds, but hear me out. I'm only saying out of bounds because I can't commit to inbounds. Because it's a guess. It's like, is it going to be red or black on roulette? I don't know. Is Kershaw going to finally be effective throughout the... I don't know. I mean, we could sit here and, you know, Garrett Cole can have another great start or two, and then if they're lucky enough to advance past the Rays, get bombed in the neck. You just don't know. So it's the one thing that should embolden Kershaw and Dodger backers is that, you know, without a 162-game season, in theory, that back should be feeling a lot better.
Yeah.
And maybe that's part of the reason, you know, even though he's missed some starts in years, you make, 30-ish starts, and you're into the postseason, it's a grind, and then usually in the seventh inning it flares up and the ERA soars through the roof. I'd like to see it because I think he deserves it, an all-time great. But I'm going to say out of bounds because baseball, there's just there's really no rhyme or reason to baseball, especially October baseball. All right, so while the SEC starts week number 2, Big Ten and the Pac-12 get to play, as we know. Many in the ACC are playing their third, some even playing fourth games here. Number 1, Clemson. You ready for a beatdown, Teak? 27.5-point dogs are the Cavaliers, but maybe they come out and they fight. I'm sure they will. Tiki's squad takes them on. While 12th-rated UNC, a team that Tiki likes a lot. He's seen him play in person. Faces undefeated Boston College. BC's not that good. D-Cell's Canes are looking really good. Another team that Tiki's been on top of from week 1. They're top 10 in the country. And temporary newcomer Notre Dame is 5th, despite battling what we all know is a major COVID issue. And not looking that great against Duke in week 1. In or out, the rest of the ACC is catching up to Clemson to consistently challenge Dabo for the conference title.
I got to say out of bounds of that one, BT. I know that they're starting to get better at recruiting and getting star players because they know that look, we have a chance to knock off one of the best teams in college football over the last half a decade. Then we and they don't want me. Meaning Clemson doesn't want me. I'm going to go to the you know, an adversary and knock them off. The teams are getting closer, but I don't think they're ready to knock off and challenge Dabo for the ACC crown, and certainly not the national championship. Yes, they're getting there. They are, but there's still works in progress for sure.
And listen, you know, you have to wonder, too, does Dabo ever get the itch to go jump in the NFL?
Good question.
I don't know.
It's a good, very good question.
You know, I don't see Dabo coaching the Jets, but if the Jaguars were as bad as we thought they might be, and Minshew sputtered, I mean, a package deal of Dabo and Trevor Lawrence wasn't totally off the table in a lot of our minds here. I agree. Well, listen, where is the evidence that teams are really closing the gap? And I don't mean by rankings. That's largely superficial. Who cares about ranking?
It
means nothing, right? Yeah. It's exactly nonsense. Where are the competitive games from a year ago? As much as we sat here and lamented, oh, Trevor Lawrence, I don't know, does it look that good the first couple of weeks? I don't know, Trevor Lawrence, what's going on with Trevor Lawrence? I mean, I'm looking at the scores here. 45-14, 45-10. These are conference games.
Yep.
59-14, 55-10, 52-3, 38-3, 62-17 against Virginia last year. I mean,
that was a championship game.
And that was the ACC championship game. Exactly. Who's challenging them? We can sit here and say, well, this team's got an 8 in front of them.
Yeah.
Here they come. Until I see it on the field, Clemson is by far the best team in the ACC. Thanks for watching. Make sure you like and subscribe. And don't forget to hit that bell to be notified when we drop fresh content.